I've always felt like a bit of an outsider. I've been comfortable in my own skin. I've not wanted to be something else. I was very nervous about that whole ensemble cast. True, I think, was the only Bengali leading man for me who I was attracted to.
I saw the trailer of Ram Prasad Ki Tervi and I really enjoyed it. But you know, when you see the trailer, you can't make out much about your character. But the one thing that I understood is that she's a misfit in a family. And now you can tell me a little bit about your character.
Right. So the film, as you know, is about, you know, the patriarch who has passed away and a family getting together. So my character is the choti bahu of the family, who is actually not from there. She's come from Bombay. So she's from outside and she's a bit of an outsider. Not an outcast, I would say. She's a bit of an outsider. She's a bit of a misfit. And she has her own issues. She can't necessarily get along with the other wives or, you know, and that's the thing in the film, because there are so many characters. Everybody is coming from their own point of view. Everybody has their own issues because they're so involved with their own emotions or, you know, egos that you can't really see the bigger picture. So what's nice is in this film that Seema Ji, who has drawn from her own experiences, she has that perspective, much broader perspective, which gives us that distance, which gives us a sense of also a certain amount of comedy or at least some lighthearted moments on such a grim and serious occasion.
Have you ever felt that you are a misfit in your family or, you know, misfit in your college, wherever?
Yeah, and not because anybody has, you know, really made me feel like that or made me, I don't know. It's not like anybody's been mean to me or, I mean, I was bullied to a certain extent when I was younger, but nothing significant. But I have always had that perspective. I've always felt like a bit of an outsider, more than a misfit. I mean, I was raised mainly by my mother as a single parent, even though I had a fantastic equation with my dad as well. So I had anyway a slightly unconventional upbringing, which made me feel very comfortable with being different from other people. Maybe it comes from that, I don't know. But I have felt like a bit of an outsider, a little bit in school, to a certain extent in college, even at work. And I think that's just more me than anybody else. But by and large, I've been comfortable in my own skin. I've not wanted to be something else.
Coming back to the film, you know, the film is packed with such an ensemble cast. Like,
yeah.
Kisko chhod ke kisko dekho? Because they're such fantastic actors.
Yeah.
How was it coming all together? It's not like you have seen with only one person here and there. They're all together in one frame. So how was that experience?
You know, to be honest, right at the beginning, I was very nervous about that whole ensemble cast. Even though it was very exciting, I was greedy to work with them. But also, they're all such veteran actors, strong theatre actors, very senior actors, with a great command over the language. All of them are Hindi speaking, so most of them have a forum. And that was making me quite, I was intimidated by that. And I remember telling Seema, you know, yaap mujhe mat lijiye, main zan nahi kar paungi, and all I was thinking. But she was very sweet and patient and kind, etc. with me. And once we were on set, because there were so many of us together, we became like a nice group, you know. Manojji was the chief in fun coordinator person, and his room was the Adda room, and you know, the weather was lovely and we were in Lucknow and there was a lot of amazing food, and somehow we all managed to form camaraderie.
Seema Pava makes her directorial debut with this film. You have been in her shoes before, like you said. Tell me what an actor can do to make the first time director feel comfortable. Any tips for the actors?
That's an interesting question. I've never thought of it like that. I don't think I've been aware of it like that. I've worked with a lot of first-time filmmakers and I love working with debutant directors because usually if it's their first film, they've been thinking about it for a while and, you know, they've lived with it for a while and they're, you know, they're eager to, like, you know, express themselves like that. So I have always enjoyed it. But I think as an actor, whether it's somebody's first film or last or in between or, you know, post a hit or, you know, an unsuccessful director, whatever, like, I think it's their job as an actor to be supportive of your director and, of course, vice versa.
Your equation with Seema Ji, how was that?
I remember very well on a couple of occasions, like some Diwali party, I think, or some other place. I've met her a couple of times. And I remember this one time where, you know, she was sitting with many people and she was telling stories. I was listening quietly, you know, but I was very taken because she's such a wonderful storyteller. Our relationship developed very nicely. I mean, none of us, I think, got much individual time from her. But during the rehearsal, she did give me some time one-on-one, which was really good. I think for me to really get into that milieu, because it's not something that is so familiar to me, because I'm a Bengali and my family background and has been very nuclear. I've been brought up largely by single parents, and I've been very urban, I didn't have that much of a, I didn't relate as much, but so she really helped me through that process. We did some sessions on our own as well. And then, of course, she's very funny and nurturing, and she knows what she wants.
Another person that I want to talk about is Soumitra Chatterjee. Since you grew up with cinema, your mom being there, how has he shaped, your perception towards this subject, cinema?
Soumitra, I think, was the only Bengali leading man for me who I was attracted to. I'm attractive on many levels. Like, of course, physically attractive, mentally attractive. Like, there's an appeal that he has that is, I feel like it's pretty pan-Indian and international. I never felt our own heroes are so embarrassing or anything. I did feel that about one or two of them, but certainly not about Soumitra, so he was one of the few people that one could look on with so much pride, and for his body of work, for the things he stood up for his varied interests as well. Not that I really knew him personally. I've heard stories from my mother. I've watched some films of theirs together. I've watched him in so countless films, of course. I've adored him in Oppu Trilogy. I was in love with him in Charulata.
Yes. Your takeaway from this year, 2020?
For me, one thing has been that, I've, in my line of work, et cetera, I've always had a driver driving me around, and I've never really had to like park and things like that much. But I have to say that during this corona, in these COVID times, when my driver wasn't there, and Ganesh has been with me for almost a decade, but he was not there. And so even though I knew how to drive, I was very, very rusty. So I really became quite self-sufficient. I was, just in the neighborhood and getting sabzi or vegetables or whatever, or just dropping into a friend's or something. I became good at parallel parking, and I was driving around. So that felt great. And even now that he's back, I'm like, I must remember to keep driving every now and then so I don't lose that again. I also embraced my curly hair. I mean, today it's straightened, but by and large, I mean, I didn't go to the salon in months, and I was just like, why did I used to go to the salon so often and spend so much time and money? So I also spend a lot of time with my son, with my family. We adopted a puppy. So these things, I cooked a fair amount early on in the lockdown. So all these things have been wonderful.
That's awesome. We just hope you have a great year. The year is going to end, and 2021 gives you all the happiness and joy that you're hoping for.
Thank you so much. I have many wishes for 2021, and let's hope they all come true.